Start it up! Start it up!
Oh no.
Start up the car!
No. No, 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 no. Oh shit.
Ignore us, right? Yeah? You're gonna ignore us, right? Start up the car.
Let's go, beautiful people. It's your boy Sean Gon Gaming, aka Call Me Sean GG. And as y'all can see, today we are playing an indie horror game called They Are Here. This is a horror game about aliens coming to abduct people from our planet, all that good stuff, yada yada yada. Y'all know. From what I know, I think this indie game is made by one person. He's been working on it for 3 years. So you know, we finna give it a try. We finna get into it. The prologue tells you the story of the first UFO contact that happened 30 years before the events shown in the demo version. The main character is Private Michael Anderson, who serves the military base near Grayson Farm. By chance, he becomes a witness of terrible and inexplicable events. Was that a meteor? Okay. Is this us now? Am I facing the right direction? Over there.
This is base. The object has landed. Your task is to identify the object without contact.
Omega without team contact. Uh-huh.
Conduct surveillance for now. Drive with care. Report when you arrive.
Okay. Can I zoom in on my camera?
5x5, sir. Out.
Oh, they're coming. Okay. At least I got someone watching from above. Okay. Yeah.
This is Omega. We see you. We are monitoring.
Oh, appreciate it. I feel so much better. I thought I was just down here by myself. Hey, don't go too far without me now. Don't.
Omega, this is Michael Anderson. I report radiation detected. Counter indicator is average.
Roger that. We're on flight here.
You know, usually you feel fucking scared as hell playing these type of things, but I feel so safe knowing I got a helicopter over here, man. Like, I feel like I can take it over the world. How far is this thing, too? Like, couldn't we have gotten a car or a dirt bike or something to get close over there? Because it's pretty, yeah, this is a pretty far walk. And then on top of that, we got stamina.
Omega, what the hell is going on with your devices? Radiation levels rising, over.
I'm pretty sure only one person made this too, for this to be only made by one person. This is pretty good, like the graphics and all, shit.
Hey, can you hear anything? Something strange is happening. Devices break down, indicators are constantly changing. You can't see, but everything breaks down at the same time. It seems that there is some kind of an anomaly here.
This is the base. Omega, stay away from the object.
What?
Observe the object from a distance.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, you just told me to come over here. Is this it? I think this is it right here. I feel like this is it. Yeah. Yeah, this got to be it. No? Oh.
What the hell's going on there?
I have no idea. Sir? Is everything fine?
Omega, fly away. Michael Anderson, follow protocol.
Oh shit! Oh no!
Fuck.
Oh, my safety. I don't feel safe anymore. I don't feel safe at all.
Can anyone hear me? Over.
Bro. It is dark as sin here. Y'all see that?
Can anyone answer?
In the distance?
Damn it.
Dude, I always, like, for my sanity, switch to night vision. Oh no, that's even worse. For my sanity, I always assume that if we get invaded, it's just gonna be like, you know they can fuck us up. So just out of them feeling like we're not a necessary threat, they'll keep the peace and all that good stuff, right? But if you think about the other option, which is they just want to fuck us up, then there's nothing we can do, and you'd run into a situation like this. And what the hell? It's a UFO, mate. That's what it is. Toggle right mouse button to zoom. Oh, that's how you zoom. Okay. Yeah, man. How do I do my knife? Oh, my bad. How do I do my knife? Okay, there we go. Damn. Wait. Red? What's red? Oh, no. Oh, no. We gotta go. What's red? Something was red on my radar, bruh. Two? Oh, no. Oh, go. Shit. It's the demo. Okay. I was for the say. I was like, damn, that's the demo? Shit. Okay. Oh, man. Unexplained phenomena occurred at Grayson Farm. On the night of August 7th, the Sherman family witnessed bright lights in the sky that moved in breakneck speed over the cornfield. The lights moved in a random direction and at a different speeds. After a while, they vanished. The strange behavior in the sky was observed at the same time each night. For 5 nights, according to the owner of the farm, all the animals went crazy. The dog became aggressive, tried to attack him and bit him. The children complained that someone was walking under the windows. Farmer Pete, Peter, Sherman himself in the field saw a strange figure that did not look like a man. What is it? Deliberate deception? Drawing attention to oneself? Or a sensation about an alien invasion? Journalist Taylor Fox travels to Grayson Farm to take a photo and make a report for the local news. So we're Taylor Fox, working for Fox News. Talk to Farmer Peter Sherman. Can I? I don't got a flashlight with this person. No, you can't do this to me, mate. Oh, shit. Press left. This is great material for the news report. Yes, I guess. Yeah. If that's. Oh, we don't got our camera yet or anything. Okay. I mean, we do because we just took a picture, but you don't see the little lines. I think this person has less stamina than the other guy. Oh, you don't got night vision. Oh, no. Farmer's note. Mr. Fox, we made an appointment, but something bad happened. Our daughter went missing. My wife went to town for help. My son and I went to check on the farm. We'll leave notes for you and the police in case we pass each other. Be careful, Peter Sherman. That's nice of you. Thanks, Peter. Can I close this door? Oh, thank you. It doesn't do much, but it makes me feel a little better. Not working. I don't know what would be more, terrifying. Hostile aliens or just ghosts? The normal, everyday ghosts. Old newspaper. Information about UFOs and crop circles. These phenomenons have been seen throughout the state for a long time. Why I've never known about this? I don't know. Do you not keep up to date with shit? Oh, Dad was drinking and reading. This photo of him and his son. Oh, they got a doggo. Is that the one that bit him? Oh, she snuck out. She snuck out, for real. Farmer's note, this is my daughter's room. During the night, I heard a strange noise. When I came in, she wasn't in her bed. And the window was wide open. I'm sure she was abducted by those things. Oh, shit. Megan. Walkie-talkie. Can we take it with us? Oh, she's getting a weird radio frequency. Okay. Oh, he was researching aliens, huh? Oh, yeah, that one's definitely creepy.
You okay?
My shit. I'm freaking out.
Yeah. Okay. What's this? Found my old diary. How could I forget that? I saw the aliens. I don't remember. How could I forget that? Today, the most exciting and scariest day of my life. I saw the aliens. My parents think I'm lying, but it's true. I was fishing from an abandoned pier on the river. Suddenly, I was defended by a roar coming from behind. I turned around very low above the ground. A huge disc with four flashing lights or windows was hovering. I felt a punch that seemed to throw me into the air. I froze there as if in zero gravity. Everything around me became blindingly bright, and I seemed to lose consciousness. I remember seeing three aliens with gray skin and big eyes. I was placed on the table as if I was welded to it. They were staring at me. It seemed to me that they communicate with each other telepathically. Then one of them came over and did something to my head. I don't remember anything else. I woke up on the pier later in the evening and barely made it home. My head was buzzing, and I walked home as if in a delirium. Oh, okay. When I was there, I found several cuts in my body and two small, very smooth holes behind my ears. What was that? I'm scared to sleep. Oh, shit. Yeah? Okay. No. I didn't shut the internet. Oh, please tell me you got a flashlight. Please tell me you got a flashlight. Thank you. I didn't get to check the... I've learned a lot from these things. They're called the Greys. They're not little green men, but big, creepy, dangerous creatures. Basically, they can be described in the following way. A large head, disproportionate to the body. Bottomless black eyes. Green skin. Oh, no, gray skin. Long, thin limbs. Their voices are like nothing else. The aliens are very aggressive towards people. It all starts with bright lights in the sky near home, which move along in a certain way. Then people start to have a nosebleed, have severe headaches, and have a buzz in their ears. And animals start raging. Next, people start to have memory lapses. When they come back to normal, they find themselves in unexpected places. For example, in the middle of the field or on the road, a few kilometers away from home, some of them have flashbacks of terrible memories. People remember terrifying experiences. The aliens established control over their minds, and this has affected their psyche. Also, they found the marks on the body, incisions to be exact. During palpation, it felt like something thick, like a foreign object moving under the skin. Y'all hear that? Why'd you turn off the light? Is someone whistling? No. 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 Mm-mm. Can I go? Take this with us. Can we escape out of here? I don't want to go downstairs. I heard something. As a child, headaches began to bother me. It tortured me to this day. I went to the doctor dozens of times, but no one could explain the reason for the occurrence. Now I understand why the doctors could not determine the cause of the migraines. The answer is simple: abduction. I only remember that the alien abduction when I found my old diary. It was then that the migraines began. The cuts that I noticed then behind my ear were a trace of them. I'm sure they've implanted something in me, some kind of transmitter or implant. Because of this, I forgot everything. I definitely decided that I would get it. I'm not crazy. Okay. Oh, shit. Is this the... Oh, he pulled this out. Little jar to which you would a strange device. You know, Peter Sherman claims he cut out an alien implant. Maybe take it? Sure, let's take it. Let's... Hello. photos of dead animals. Oh shit. Okay. Why is this working? We sit down, get some popcorn. Invisible gray men. Or they didn't say invisible today, they just what? I don't know what that means. Okay. Okay. No. You just assume at that point it's something. You don't even check, just assume. They are outside. They are behind this door. Is there another way to get out? Has to be another way to get out. Well, I'm going to my car. You want another picture? Oh, shit. Oh, one of them just left. Yeah, we're going in the car. Nah, we're getting out. Oh, no. Oh, shit. Run. Go. 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 Make it to the car. Make it to the car. I'm running. I am. I'm already running. Why are you so up your stamina? Please go work out after this. Please! Oh, go. Start it up! Start it up! Oh, no. Start up the car! No. No, 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 no. Oh, shit. Right? Yeah? You're gonna ignore us, right? Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Start up the car! Start the car! Start up the car! In a full game, you will find a large territory of Grayson Farm and a full story of alien induction. Add the game to your wish list. Da, 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 da. Okay. All right, guys. That was They Are Here. I like it. I see some promise in it. The only thing I'm going to ask for the creator is please give me more stamina. I mentally cannot take not being able to run away from shit on here. I hate that with a passion. I'm not asking for much. just give me enough to, I'd say, at least make a full sprint from the door to the car. That's all. Because I was panicking. I don't like to panic. Okay. But yeah, guys. Yeah, that was that. We're here. I will put the creator's, what was it? What was it? His Reddit? Reddit or something? I'll put it, whatever socials I can get from him in here so y'all can ask him about his game and stuff. Yeah, I think the thing said he was working on this for like 3 years. So yeah, that's some dedication. But yeah, it's dope. Definitely is dope. But anyway, guys, that's going to be it for this one. If you like the video, you know what to do. Thumbs up, sub, all that good stuff. And I will catch y'all in the next one.